I love games with movement mechanics. Whether you're sliding at intense speeds, jumping through portals, or flying like an eagle, movement maketh game. The mechanic doesn't even need to be intentional. I just want to be able to move fast and feel cool doing so. However, you'd be hard-pressed to find a game with more refined movement than Celeste. Everything is just so clean, and the movement is so fluid, so natural. And that's just what it looks like when I play. Watching someone who actually knows what they're doing is next level. But Celeste has a problem. You die. A lot. Like, all of this is just what happened when I was recording footage for this opening. So, what if I could take all that failure and shift it into an AI, so I don't need to deal with all the pain and suffering that comes with playing this game? The first thing we need to figure out is how I'm actually going to train an AI to play this game. I'm going to be using a very basic genetic algorithm. I don't actually know if it has a name, so I'm just going to call it the monkey model. There's an old saying, give a million monkeys a million typewriters, and eventually they'll write out the entire works of Shakespeare. So, I'm posing a simple question. If I give a million computers a million copies of Celeste, will it eventually complete the game? To start, I needed a simple test environment, navigate a dot to a target. Each turn, the dot will be able to move in one of the four cardinal directions. Each dot has a randomly generated list of movements, and it completes these movements in order. These dots are the monkeys, and a couple of them are starting to write Shakespearean prose. Most of them are writing gibberish, and others are writing the opening to Marx's Communist Manifesto. That's how randomness works. Some move in the direction you want, and others don't. Then of all these dots, we delete all except for the five closest to the target. Then we clone the closest five, but during the cloning process, we mutate the arrays, with either an insertion, a deletion, or a swap. Run this process enough times, and eventually the dots will finally make it to their target. So now this needs to be applied to Celeste. The first question is, how do we get the distance in Celeste? A problem with this game is that the camera moves around a lot, and there aren't any good tools to extract data from memory locations like I used in my Smash Bros. Project. However, when I was on the Celeste website, something caught my eye. Wait, Celeste Classic, what is this? Oh my god, this looks terrible. But seems to be basically the same game. Celeste started as a game jam, and Celeste Classic is the result of that jam. Mechanically, it's nearly identical to Celeste, at least the opening of Celeste, only notably lacking climbing. And although the visuals are clearly pretty different, many of Celeste's levels are taken straight from Celeste Classic. However, the key difference here is that the camera doesn't move, which means we can get data from it using computer vision. Each tick, we take a screenshot of the game, then we use OpenCV to only filter for certain colors, then we look at all the borders between the black and white, then draw a box around that. Now we have the location of the character's head, and the score can be based on the height of that character. Then we can move the character just by simulating keyboard inputs. This method works, and it was able to beat the first level, after about 30 hours of training. Needing to run the game at real speed, combined with the fact that I can only have one agent running at a time, meant that this method would just be too slow. Additionally, the keyboard input method had some timing precision errors that would lead to small differences between runs, so the positioning would be slightly off, leading to deaths. This means that I needed to do what I promised myself I would not do at the start of this project. I needed to remake the game. So, now I needed to use some of those non-existent game dev skills. To start, I wanted the movement to look and feel like it did in the original. I downloaded Unity, created a project, and added a square. I made the square move left and right, and allowed it to jump. Next, dashing. I did this just by setting the character's velocity to a constant value every frame for a set amount of frames. I also made the square blue when this happens. Then everything needed to look fancy, because those squares don't quite match the aesthetic of the original game. So I stole some sprites, and for the hair, I added a basic trail effect in Unity. As you progress, there are new mechanics introduced, including springs, which just set the vertical velocity of the player, clouds, which are moving one-way platforms, balloons, which replenish dashing, blocks that break after 3 seconds, and double dashing, which I really should have thought about before making dashing originally, because it required me to rewrite a good chunk of code. Before, I said we can look at how high the agent goes, but this has a problem. Some of the levels have a path that is not just straight up, but a little more curvy. So instead of scoring by height, There are a series of numbered checkpoints, and the score of the agent is equal to the highest checkpoint number reached. In order to keep the game looking like the original, the game is made from screenshots of the original, with invisible hitboxes everywhere. Huge shout out to the Celeste team for giving me permission to still open source this project even with those stolen images included. After all of that, it was just a matter of creating each level using the tools I made, and then just artisanally infusing the game with the monkey model. As a final touch, all the characters are going to be dimmed except for one, which shows the current best run. But before training begins, I just want to take a second to say, each of these videos takes me hundreds of hours to make, as in literally hundreds of hours, that's not an exaggeration. So if you like this video, then maybe consider turning that little red subscribe button gray, or sharing this video with your friends, or just commenting to boost the algorithm. And with that, it's time to pump the Creative Commons license music and get training. 3, 2, 1, go. We'll be right back.
Let's go!
The AI discovered skips that I didn't even know were possible. On the left, I have the real speed AI run-through of the game. Side by side, you can notice some differences between my version of the game and the original, but in general, it's close enough that the entire path can be followed. As always, the code will be available on GitHub, link in the description. Also, huge thank you to everyone who now supports me on Patreon. It may not atone for your sins, but it's definitely pretty nice. And especially big thank you to top tier patrons like FudgePop01, who gave me even more money. Okay, I'm pretty bad at this, and I don't really know what to say, but yeah, Patreon, if you have money you don't want, I'll happily take it from you. But seriously, to everyone watching, thank you so much. The amount of support from the last video has just been amazing. So thank you everyone. I really hope you enjoyed this video. So like, share, subscribe, yada yada. Stay safe. See you next time. Ma ci sento a tocino d'amor. Delle belle tornando a riposo. Ma ci sento a tocino d'amor. Fra guerrieri può far bacco. Quando sta chi stretto sacco. Schioppo in spalla, ciabla a fianco. Collo dritto, muso franco. Un gran casco, un gran turbante, molto onor, poco cantante. Ed invece del fandango, una marcia per il fango, per montagni, per valloni, nevi e salioni al concerto di tromboni, di bombarde e di cannoni, che le porre tutti tuoni, all'orecchio fan fischiar. Non più vrai quei penachini, non più vrai quel cappello, non più vrai quella chioma, non più vrai quell'aria brillante. Non più vrai farfalloni amoroso, notte giorno di torno gerato, delle belle tornando a riposo, ma ci sei tu ad un cino d'amor. Delle belle tornando a riposo, ma ci sei tu ad un cino d'amor. Che rovino alla vittoria, alla gloria militar, che rovino alla vittoria, alla gloria militar, alla gloria militar, alla gloria militar.